Hey guys, Vince here at SensorStick Forum, and I'm gonna take you through the removal process of this nasty unwanted software. Now this video is gonna be composed of two parts: automatic removal for the first part, and then I'm gonna take you through how a manual removal would be done. So before we begin this video, I'd like to say that you should never trust sites that have no real people behind them or video guides, and you should always make sure to back up your files before doing any removal by yourself, and always use trustworthy sources. Make sure that these are real people behind these videos, because many people do this for money and they may scam you. Now, for the automatic removal, we're gonna use the help and the power of an advanced anti-malware software. To download it, open your video's description and click on the description link. It's gonna take you to our tailor-made removal guide for this specific threat. Now, then go ahead and click on the download button, which is gonna take you to the download page. It should start automatically, and when it does, simply open the installer. The installer is rather simple. All you have to do is choose your language, and then you're gonna have to click on OK, and then all you have to do is click on continue, then agree with the policy and click on install. When the install is finished, the scan should start immediately. All you have to do is click on finish and wait for the scan to complete. It's gonna detect any cookies, malware, adware, objects that are tracking you, and so on and so forth. When the scan is done, it's gonna show you the detected items. All you have to do is mark them with your mouse and remove it. Now, this is very convenient and a fast method to do it. It's as easy as that, guys. Okay, so let's get on with the manual removal process. Now, for manual removal, first I'm gonna show you how you can uninstall this threat in case it's installed on your computer as a program. You're gonna have to type appwiz.cpl in your run window, and you can open it by typing Windows button plus the key R. When you do that, it's gonna take you to programs and features. All you have to do is locate the suspicious program, mark it with your mouse, and then click on uninstall. This will make sure the program is gone from your computer. And when the program is uninstalled, all you have to do is clear up your web browsers. Now I'm gonna take you through most of the browsers. For Google Chrome, you're gonna have to open Chrome, and in your address bar, type chrome://settings and then clear browser data. This will open the clear browser data window, which when you open it, you're gonna select on the time range, all time. And when you do that, you're gonna tick everything besides passwords and other sign-in data. And then you're gonna click on the clear data button. Easy as that. Now you've cleared all the trackers and all the cookies that may be caching on your computer and tracking you. To clear any malicious extensions, you're gonna click on the three dots on the top right, more tools, and then extensions. Locate any suspicious extensions and click on remove to get rid of them. And basically that's it, guys. We've now taken care of how a removal would go with Google Chrome. Now, let's go through Mozilla Firefox. For Firefox, you're gonna have to open the browser, and on the address bar, you're going to type about /support. This will open the support page. In it, you will find a button that is called Refresh Firefox. You're gonna click on that button to refresh all of the Firefox settings by default. It's gonna take you to a fast process which clears cookies, browsing history, and so on and so forth. Click on finish to finish it, and as you can see here, it says success. Firefox will save your old good configuration on your desktop, so you can locate any passwords or anything you may have missed if it's your default browser. For Microsoft Edge though, it's very simple to Chrome. So you're gonna open it, and in the address bar you're gonna type the same thing: Edge, settings, and then clear browser data. This is also gonna take you to a very similar to Chrome window, because Edge is based on Chrome. You're gonna select all time, you're gonna tick everything besides passwords, and then you're gonna clear now. And when it's done, you're gonna clear of any extensions by again going on the right corner and clicking on extensions. This will take you to any suspicious extensions which you can detect and remove, again just like Chrome, by clicking on the remove button. And that's it, now we've got Edge covered. The next browser I'm gonna show you is Opera. In Opera browser, you're gonna click on Opera, and you're gonna go to the address bar, and then you're gonna type Opera /settings clear browser data. It's very similar to what Edge and Chrome actually do. So you're gonna click on advanced, and then you're gonna tick everything, select all time, you know the drill, guys. Like, select everything, settings, hosted data, and then click on clear data. And basically, that's it for the browsers. So with this, hopefully you should have get rid of this nasty adware threat. Thanks for watching, guys. We hope this video helped you. We appreciate if you'd subscribe, comment. We respond fast to any comments, so make sure to ask us any questions if anything is not clear. Thanks for watching, guys.